a little while from now, I'm going to be allowing persons to say, send greetings to their loved ones. It will be for 15 minutes. So make it short and spicy. Thank you. Yes, you're given 15 minutes to say greetings. And to say whatever you feel. What if some, maybe you might have a testimony that you want to share with us. You're given this 15 minutes right now to send your greetings. Go ahead with your call. Good morning, caller.
Hello, good morning.
Yes, ma'am, go ahead now.
I like to send greetings to my son, Damian Phillips. He's a security at SDC in Port Antonio. My next two sons, Kevin and Tajuan. My friends in Fair Hill. Alexia, Kamaya, Felisa and their mother. Mrs. Bailey, Sharon Bailey. Tell them how much I love them. I'd like to send greetings to the Ginger House Assembly Adventist Church.
And you are?
Maxine Phillips.
Where are you calling from, Miss Phillips?
Ginger House.
Okay, have yourself a pleasant afternoon and good morning.
Yes, and to my husband, Pineda Phillips. And please play a gospel for me, please.
Which one?
Any gospel for me, please.
Okay, ma'am. Thanks for calling.
Okay, yeah.
Remember, you're given this 15 minutes of the program to send your greetings or to share a testimony or to ask for prayer at this time, live on the telephone. As we ask the Lord for a praying spirit, that's what each one of us should ask for this morning. Because sometimes I tell you, flesh can't do it. So we have to learn how to pray in the spirit.
When you don't know what you're saying, when you're moaning.
We have to learn how to pray in the spirit. We have been given this gift from the Holy Spirit himself, and we take it lightly. We tend to brush it aside, but understand it. The devil ate this gift, and that is why he allow people to be ignorant about it. So we need to start praying in the spirit by faith. Some persons still not launch out to do it yet. But let us acknowledge the gift of tongues and why it was given. And let us use it, especially in times like now when everything gone up and everybody are worried about war. When you pray in the spirit, it gives you a peace.
Lord, give us a heart like David, who was known as a man after God's own heart, who stated in Psalms 42, as the deer pants for the water brook, so pants my soul after you, God. Thirst for you, Jesus.
I'm running after you. You're watching over me with your arms open.
And this one is coming out of the voice of Judy Jacobs.
I can hide. You are my heart's design. There is
just want to say good morning to my mother, to my husband, and to my children.
I find he...
A pleasant good morning to Crystal Miller over there in Maine, Algonquin. Want to big up all the Massive and crew from Kem, Jamaica, and Canada. Bless up on yourself. Good morning. And as we worship him, let us tell him this morning in this song.
So much wise than the wise. You see, Lord, I've got hope. And I find he.
And as we worship the King of Kings this morning, just want to say a pleasant good morning to Balford and the crew in Panama City, Florida. Also want to say good morning to Stephanie and the family. Is he our heart's desire this morning? What is it that is so dear that we are desiring more? Do we make Jesus the one who is our Lord, who is our Savior, the one who we practice the presence of him in our lives? Trust me, listen to the song.
Lord, we lift our hands in worship. Your holy name, you deserve our glory.
Surely he deserves our glory. When I stop to think about what he did and what he's still doing, after fuck, nobody else in my life deserves this honor more than him. He deserves glory, he deserves honor, he deserves praise. There's nobody in my life that I can compare to the King of Kings this morning. I love my family dearly. But when it comes on to the King, he's number one. And this one is saying, good morning, Sister Victoria. I'm a Christian, but I notice when I'm praying, I don't pray out loud. I pray in my mind. I just can't pray out loud. Does the Lord still hear me? I'm listening.
Nobody else like you.
sister, the Lord hear you. He hears you. Just think on something and He knows what you're thinking. You don't have to pray out loud. There are times when I'm traveling in public vehicles and I'll be there taking authority over demonic situation and it moves. How much more the Lord? Yes, He's listening. He knows who you are. And I'm sure this morning that He hears you all the time you pray. This one said, good morning. Could you say hello to the Poister family in Negril? From Car Green in Tampa, Florida. Big up yourself, sweetheart. God bless you.
Oh, come on, one more time. Like you do in the morning. How many want to stay there? Come on.
As we worship Him this morning, let us realize who He is. Let us acknowledge the King.
In the morning, gently rest upon my heart. Oh, y'all may be seated in His presence. Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord. I want you to rest, Jesus.
Come on, can we ask the Lord to rest upon our hearts?
Rest, Jesus. Rest, Jesus. Like the dew, like the dew. Like the dew in the morning.
Fresh.
Rest.
Let there be a freshness. Let there be a fresh anointing, a fresh wind. We release it to the persons listening this morning. We release the freshness of Jesus Christ, the host of heaven, to all listeners this morning. We release that fresh anointing. Father, I release you in this place. Holy Spirit of God, I release you in this place. I release you to the atmosphere. I release you to the people. I release you to the mass. I release you. I release you. I release you. I release you this morning. Holy Spirit of God, as you change the atmosphere, as you change the lives of your people, as you change, as you bring changes to homes and family, God, we release you to them this morning.
Sister Madge, go get Tashana Blackwell for me.
Kiss of the glory and the honor.
This one said, good morning, Mistress Victoria. Can you please give a shout out to my daddy, Mr. Easton Hunter in Guantanamo Bay, Cuba, and this is coming from Kyra. Kyra, good morning. Mr. Easton Hunter over there in Guantanamo Bay, good morning, sir.
My hands in worship, and I bless your holy name, for you are great. You do miracles so great.
Can we tell Him this morning? Hallelujah. This one said, good morning, please pray for 6 children and my daughter Tat. Run away, leave his little brother, his little baby. Please pray that she come back in the home.
How many know that you can think about something that the Lord has done for you?
Whoever is calling, I just wanted to listen to this song first. Person sending this text, listen to this song. And just begin to praise God this morning with me.
Are you seeking a place to rent, seeking employment, or have a job vacancy? Are you selling a car or having a garage sale? Then come see us. Let Styles do the advertising for you and you'll be on your way in no time. Contact us at 876-286-9216 or 439-5160. Advertising Style. Advertise with Styles.
Styles FM on the go, you can listen to your favorite programs by calling the USA number 213-992-4360. If you're in the UK, it's 020-3670-1330.
One stop driver. I'm in a farm store, me a go. It's there me get all my farm supplies, animal feeds, herbicides, all my woman garden supplies. You don't see how my chicken them fat and healthy. The Miller's Farm Store, located at 3 Bungle Crescent, Port Antonio, Portland. Them open from Mondays to Saturdays, 9 a.m. to 8 p.m. and Sundays, 7 a.m. to 1 p.m. Miller's Farm Store, the best farm store in town.
Jamaica, you are invited to the first annual Light in My World Conference to be held at the Hotel Timbambo in Port Antonio, Portland on the 20th of November. It will be a day of healing and deliverance with your host, Minister Victoria Miller. Yes, the little lady with the big voice on Styles FM. Call 583-4479 to make your reservation. Come and be blessed.
This is Light in My World.
Lift your hands and just worship him. He deserves the glory. He deserves it.
Can we just worship the King of Kings this morning?
Open your mouth and begin to speak to him.
Want
to
pray for that, those 6 children and Tat, the daughter who has left home and leave the baby. Father, we thank you, Almighty God, for keeping her where she is, Almighty God. We thank you that you are with her, Almighty God. We thank you for your protection over her life, Almighty God. And so, Almighty God, we pray this morning, Almighty God, that she will return home. We pray, Almighty God, that you will speak to her mind. We send the word to Tot right now. Tot, wherever you are, we say to you this morning, go back home. Whatever it is that you think you're seeking can only be found in God. And so right now, we thank you, Father, as you restore her. We release salvation to Tot this morning. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth, we command the enemy to loose her right now and let her go. We command her. We command her to be made whole in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And Father, we thank you. We thank you, Almighty God, as you restore her. In Jesus' name. And this one said, good morning, sister. Greetings coming from Patrick Cole in Guantanamo Bay, Cuba. Good morning, Mr. Patrick Cole. Blessings. This one said, good morning. Please pray for Miss Leaford, for Leaford, Marvin, and Joyce as they get over their problems. God bless you. Father, we thank you for the two. We give you praise and honor for them, Almighty God, that you are still with them in spite of what, Almighty God, you are great. And so this morning, Father, we pray for their strength. We pray their strength, Almighty God, that they will be strong in you and they will allow your joy to be their strength. We pray for knowledge. We pray for understanding, God, where the problem is, where the situation is, Almighty God, that they will understand what is the enemy is using the problem to do, Almighty God, and that they will not be moved, Father God, but they will stand flat-footed for you, knowing, Almighty God, that you are with them, and that you'll never leave them nor forsake them. And so this morning, Almighty God, we command problem to back up. We command the enemy to step down in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And Father, we thank you for their deliverance. In Jesus' name.
Somebody begin to praise the Lord tonight. Somebody begin to give it over to God tonight. Give them your heart, give them your mind, give them your soul, give them your will.
And this person said, pray for me to get true answers straight from the heart. Thank you. Well, I really don't know who is it you want to answer you straight from the heart, but we pray that you will get the answer that you're looking for in Jesus' name. We pray that you'll get the right answer from the King. Good morning, please pray for my daughter Cydia that ran away. Leave the baby. Please pray that she come in. Oh, so it wasn't Tat. No, it's Cydia, and we already pray for her.
Thank you.
this one say, hello, good morning. I'm asking you to please pray for me. I'm having a hard time at my work and for my... This one say, good morning, I'm having a hard time at my work. Please pray for me, and my sister is expecting a baby where the father has turned the back upon her. Father, we thank you this morning, Almighty God, that you are God, that there is nothing too hard for you. You are named above all names. And so this morning we come to you, the many-breasted one. The one who speak and it was done. Yes, Lord, you command and it was steadfast. This morning, Lord and Father, we put this lady into your hand. We ask, Lord and Father, when you will direct her path. We come against every hindrance up to our job, Almighty God. Whatever is going on with that job, Almighty God, we command the enemy to step down this morning. And we speak peace into that workplace, into that workforce. Whatever is going on around our job, Father God, we call for the peace of God to it right now. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ of Nazareth. And Father God, where this daughter is concerned that is expecting, we thank you, Almighty God, for safe delivery. We thank you, Almighty God, for strength. We thank you, Almighty God, that as you do what you see fit in this, Almighty God, we pray that you will be glorified. Father, we pray, Almighty God, that you will keep this person that is expecting. We pray for the Father, Almighty God, that he will seek to understand. Father God, we come against the spirit of fear that is tormenting this mind. And Father God, we pray, Almighty God, that these two people, Almighty God, will come in agreement. Father, we thank you for agreement for this matter, Almighty God. In Jesus' name. Okay, this one said, please, please pray for the Dixon family. I don't know what to pray about, Dixon family, please. When you send your text, please tell me what to pray about. This one said, good morning, my name is Nelisa Richards. I would like you to read a word of prayer with me for two of my young church sisters was turned at different paths. I wish for them to come back on the path and walk the road to glory with me. Please pray for them. Thank you. Father, I thank you for those two. Lord, you know them by name. You know them by number. But God, even as they, you did not join us to any church or any place, Almighty God. You want us to join, to be joined to your Son. And so this morning, I pray, Almighty God, for insight. I pray for vision to these two young people. I pray, Almighty God, that you, Almighty God, will join them to yourself. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, Lord, we release salvation to them, God. We pray for them, Almighty God, that they will get understanding, they will get wisdom. They will know you for who you are, Almighty God. And so, Father God, while they are out there looking, Almighty God, I pray, Almighty God, that you yourself will show forth your face in Jesus' name.
To pay the debt of sin for everyone. Who can win the victory over death, hell, and the grave? It's the Lion of the tribe of Judah, Jesus Christ, the Son.
This one said, please pray a word of prayer for daughter to be successful in whatever she do. Father, I thank you for that child, for that daughter. I thank you, Lord and Father, that you know her. You predestinate her life to be in the earth at such a time as this, God. And so, Almighty God, you know what you want her to be successful in and what you don't want her to be in, Almighty God. And so I pray, Almighty God, for your will to be done over that child, over that daughter, over that person. Your will be done in that life, Almighty God. Father God, wherever there is struggling, you know. And so this morning we pray your help, Almighty God, in this person, that this person will be awakened to your righteousness. This person will be awakened to your love. This person will be awakened to your peace, God. Father God, I come against every tormenting spirit that torments this person, Almighty God. And I pray, Almighty God, for peace in that person's life. And I give you the honor, Almighty God. I give you the glory as you bring it about, as you manifest it, and as you establish yourself to her. In Jesus' name I pray.
I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continually be in my mouth. My soul shall make her boast in the Lord.
And this one said, my name is Rochelle, asking you to pray for me and my family. And Rochelle, I oftentimes ask you, what do you need me to pray about? The Lord is good. The Lord is merciful. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and the family and give you his peace. Amen. Okay, and this one says, please pray for the Dixon family that we can get over our problem. Father, we thank you this morning that you are a problem solver, that there is nothing too hard for you where you are concerned. Father God, and as these people text in to ask, Almighty God, that we pray, we join faith with them this morning, Almighty God. And Almighty God, we thank you for strength in those problem times, Almighty God, in those difficult times. Father God, you said we, our strength is your joy. And so this morning we release the joy of the Lord to the Dixon family. We release the joy of the King to you this morning. And we thank you, Father, as you tabernacle among them and bring them your joy so that they can be strengthened in times of problem. We pray for wisdom, we pray for understanding, that as they go through the problem, they will see the answer. In Jesus' name. Yeah. this one said, good morning, Miss Sharp. We feel as if we are at home when we listen to you. And this is coming from Donovan Neal and Balfour in Panama City. Donovan Neal and Balfour, the Lord blesses you. The Lord make his face to shine upon you and give you his peace. God bless. And as we welcome the Holy Spirit in our life, we want to acknowledge His presence that He's with us. This one said, morning, sis, could you please pray for Simone, who has been suffering with anxiety disorder? Need a financial breakthrough. Need the Spirit of the Lord to lead me back to glory. Father, this morning we thank you, Almighty God, that your word says that we should be anxious for nothing, but with through all things, with prayer and supplication, we must make our requests known to you, Almighty God. And so I pray for Simone this morning, and I say to Simone's spirit, be still and know that God is God. He is King in the good time. He is King in the bad time. Whatever time you're going through, Simone, the Lord God is King forevermore. And so we come against every spirit of anxiety. We command that spirit to bow to the Lordship of Jesus Christ. We come against the spirit of depression in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, and we speak peace into your situation, Simone. And Father, I thank you right now that as you begin to change the life of Simone, as you begin to be Almighty God, her shepherd, as you begin to mold her, as you begin, Almighty God, to straighten out things on her behalf, Almighty God, she will acknowledge you for who you are. She will experience you and the joy that comes from you. Father, we bless you for changing the atmosphere, for doing big change in her life, Almighty God. We release salvation and peace over Simone right now. Through your name we pray, Father. Amen. And I know that is one of the sisters. This one said, good morning, want you to pray for my son Ryan Allen. Sometimes he behaves too ignorant and mad. Father, I thank you. I thank you this morning, Almighty God, that you said children is an inheritance of the Lord. And so, Almighty God, you have given our children to us, Almighty God, for us to inherit them, Almighty God. And Father, we see where the devil has stepped in and he has caused controversy. We see where he's stealing the children's lives, Almighty God. Father God, just the other day I was listening to the news, Almighty God, where these children was massacred by the enemy, Almighty God. But today, Almighty God, we pray for the children of our nation, Almighty God, that the enemy will not, Almighty God, be successful in taking their lives, in giving them short-lived lives, Almighty God. But we pray today for long lives over your people, Almighty God, over your children, because we understand, Almighty God, that our children is tomorrow's future in what you are doing, Almighty God. And so right now, we send the word of God into the nations, over the children, and we speak long life, we speak success, we speak prosperity to our Jamaican children and to the world's children. And Father God, to this son, we thank you, Almighty God, as you, God, humble him, as you, God, bring him into the light, as you, God, make him to see your face. We come against every attack of the enemy that is pouncing upon him, Almighty God. And we speak and we release the mind of Christ to this son right now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And Father, we thank you as you usher in our children, as you usher them in, Almighty God, from the east and from the west and from the north and from the south. We receive them in the mighty name of Jesus, and we release the peace of God over the children of Jamaica. And Father, we thank you that we don't speak against them as one with authority. We don't put them down, Almighty God. We don't talk about what they are not and what they are doing, but we lift them up to you, God. And we ask, God, that you will direct their paths. We ask that you will bring them out of darkness. We ask, God, when you will save them. We ask, Lord, when you will sanctify them. And so we release salvation to the children, to the youth. And we thank you, Almighty God, that you will be strong for them in spite of what the enemy is doing. You will be strong for them, Lord. And so we bless you again and again. And we release peace to this son, peace to this family, peace to this mother, peace in the family right now, peace in the home, peace in their atmosphere, Almighty God. And we thank you, Father, for having all that we say today done in Jesus' name.
Sin will never take control. Life and death stood face to face. Darkness tried to steal my heart away. Thank you, Jesus. Mercy said no.
Can't afford to miss it. The Road to Glory, your Sunday morning gospel and inspirational music program on Styles 96.1 from 9 a.m. until 12 noon. Tune in. Styles, the People Station.
I'm on the go. I'm on the go. I'm on the go. I'm on the go.
You've been standing like that beside the radio all day. Haven't you heard about Styles FM On The Go?
With Styles FM On The Go, you can listen to your favorite programs by calling the USA number 213-992-4360. If you're in the UK, it's 020-3670-1330.
It's that easy? Wow! Styles FM On The Go? I like it!
One-stop driver! Miller's Farm Store, me a go. It's there me get all my farm supplies, animal feeds, herbicides, all my woman garden supplies. You don't see how my chicken them fat and healthy. The Miller's Farm Store, located at 3 Bonville Crescent, Port Antonio, Portland. Them open from Mondays to Saturdays, 9 a.m. to 8 p.m. and Sundays, 7 a.m. to 1 p.m. Miller's Farm Store, the best farm store in town.
Jamaica. you are invited to the first annual Light in My World Conference to be held at the Hotel Timbambo in Port Antonio, Portland on the 20th of November. It will be a day of healing and deliverance with your host, Minister Victoria Miller. Yes, the little lady with the big voice on Stars FM. Call 583-4479 to make your reservation. Come and be blessed.
You're tuned into Light in My World.
Since I just got a text on my cell phone saying, please pray for my husband that the Lord will save him before it's too late. Father, I thank you right now for that husband where this wife is so concerned of his saving, Almighty God. Right now, Father, we know that you love him even more than this wife. You love this man, Almighty God. But Father, we thank you, Almighty God, for wisdom. We thank you for understanding. We thank you, Almighty God, that you will give the wife wisdom, give her understanding, Almighty God, as she deal with him, understanding that she's asking for prayer. It tells me, Almighty God, that she's a Christian, she's saved. But Almighty God, you know, Almighty God, what can be done through this man, through this wife being a Christian, Father God. And as she have this concern that her husband be saved out of love, Almighty God, we know that the enemy is going to come at her very hard through the husband. And so right now, Almighty God, we thank you for wisdom. We thank you for understanding and how she will angle these matters of this husband, and that she will not give up on him this easily, but she will intercede, she will fast, she will pray to kill the flesh, Almighty God, to kill her senses, to put her senses under subjection, that she will know, Almighty God, how to minister to this husband, Father. And so, Almighty God, we more pray her strength right now than even the strength of this man, Father God. Because where this man is concerned, Almighty God, her salvation can be determined through this wife. And so, Almighty God, I pray for wisdom. I pray for understanding for this wife, that as she begin to receive wisdom and understanding, that she will lead her husband to you. And so, Almighty God, we thank you, and we release salvation over this man right now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. And we thank you, Father, for allowing your will to be done in Jesus' name.
To destroy my life, he's robbed, abused, accused, and stole. He's done everything he could.
And taking one more text, and then we'll go to the word. Last week we did not get to finish, and I'd like to finish that this week. And this one said, please pray for me and my husband to get a job. I've been unemployed for 4 months now, and I have 4 sons and 3 going to school, and I pray for me to keep the faith as a Christian. Father God, we thank you for provisions. We know, Almighty God, that you are not just going to put provisions in place where these people are concerned, Almighty God. We know, Almighty God, that the provisions have already been made available. Father God, your work is finished where our provisions is concerned. And so, Almighty God, as she adhered to your word, Almighty God, as she stand upon your word this morning, Almighty God, she will see the manifestation of these provisions, Father God. Help her to trust you. Help her to understand who you are and who she is to you, Almighty God. Help her to exercise her faith. And not just to exercise her faith, Almighty God, but to get rid of doubt and unbelief. To get them away, that they will not counterbalance her faith, Lord God. That she should trust wholeheartedly in you, because you have already made these provisions available. And so, Almighty God, as she trusts you, Almighty God, we thank you for the manifestation of all that she needs, and her children and her family. We thank you for employment in Jesus' name. Amen.
You know, the Bible says that the joy of the Lord is our strength. And when we can put our trust in the Lord, when we begin to rejoice and when we begin to praise him, it's amazing what God will do. He will give peace that surpasses all understanding.
And we will go back to our text.
Hallelujah. Bring it up.
After the word.
And give me another chance. And I know in my heart I know beyond the shadow of a doubt that he will never leave me, he will never forsake me. Oh, sing it with me. I still have his love. I still have his love. I still have his love. After all I've been through, I still have his love. Still have God's love. I've made mistakes, but I still have his love. Oh, I still have his love. I still have joy. I still have joy.
Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Father, I give you praise. I give you honor and I give you glory. I make myself available to you, Lord, that you can do what you see necessary through me. This morning we are going to be going back to Ephesians 4 and verse 10 to 13. And last week we was reading this chapter, and verse 10 said, He that descended is the same also that ascended up from above all heavens, that he might fill all things. Verse 11 said, and he gave some apostles, and some prophets, and some evangelists, and some pastors, and some teachers. We tell you last week about the administration of these offices and gifts. At the same time, although some people just see it as office and then functioning at these things, and what they really are, you have to be gifted to function in these areas. You see, if the gifts is what the Holy Spirit gave. And these come with offices. And so this morning we want to elaborate a little on them. Last week we tell you what the pastor is about. And we I'm sure I leave homework with some persons to Google what leadership mean. And we said that a pastor means to be a leadership. A pastor is not necessarily one who lord over, who rules over the church, who, when they say, when me talk, no dog bark, and all of them something there, because that is not love. When a pastor, he or she pastor out of love, with meekness, as I said last week, a pastor is like a mother who know how to nurture and to bring up a child. And so it is with our pastors. Our pastors, we have to understand how to take certain matters on. And I'm not going to say we were born with this skill, but we have been given the gifts. And sometimes we don't know exactly as pastors how to deal with certain situations. But that is why we are given the gifts. That is why we are given the Holy Spirit. So we can ask him, how do I deal with this one? We are never alone and making decision. And there are times when we see pastor in some ministry, they are hasty about making decision. They hear something and they act. But I want to say to you this morning, you have the Holy Spirit. And this thing that you are in, it's supposed to be a gift. So if you are gifted, it means then that you will know what to do in any given situation, because you have the Spirit of God on the inside of you. So it's not for you to go around the church and being busybody and making trouble when you hear something or act out out of self. You are not placed in the church to act out of self, but you are placed there to nurture and to bring up people into maturity. And when I look around in religious bodies too, I tend to see pastors who allow their members to be on one stage. There is no growth. There is no pulling on the congregation. And so they continue to let the children come to them and say, "Mommy or Daddy, tie my shoes lace." And we don't teach them how to tie it. And even though they have been growing, they still don't know how to tie the shoelace. And a lot of things that they should be doing after they come in. The nurture that they are supposed to be getting is not there. And I want to say to leaders and ministers this morning, the office that you are given, there is a function, and it is to lead people to growth. People must grow. And that is what Ephesians is saying to us this morning. That why this gift was given was to perfect the church. Verse 12 say that for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, and for the edifying of the body of Christ. So though people come to God, the ministers are there to perfect them, to bring them into maturity. So people need to come into maturity. And we have seen that pastors, so you go to some ministry, the pastor is a one-man band. You know, allow nobody else to do nothing. You know, allow just me, myself, and I. And they take on the whole fivefold ministry, even though some of them not even blessed with the gift for this fivefold ministry. And so, in a congregation, the fivefold ministry must be activated. It must be there. The ministering body will not be effective in what God called them to do if the fivefold ministry is not there. And so we want to say to leaders this morning, know who you is and what you are about, because this is it. God no call people to make them still foolish. Right? As some people say, call fool, but you no keep fool. And so it is, we need to see people growing in the body of Christ. We need to see people coming into the man, the true man of Christ. And so that is what ministers are there for. You are gifted to bring people into maturity. And so many times you see ministers act ignorantly about simple matters. Simple matters. And so we need to know whose we are and who we are in God. And so this morning, God gave ministry gifts so that we might be developing the church. The church need to be unified, having the true knowledge of the Son of God. Where that is concerned, there is a lack. People still do not know what they are supposed to know about the Son of God and why he came and what they are supposed to do and all of that. And I say to you that you have been given this gift to develop the church. Use it wisely. And show the people the knowledge of the Son. Give the people the knowledge of the Son. And stop giving people religious knowledge. And that is what we see that is trickling down in our denomination. And that is why the church cannot be united. Because we have our own denominational belief. And we set them up above even the rule of God. And we think that those things govern our body. And I said last week, then if you go ahead and think, say, what you doing at your denomination is the answer, then you have your own body carrying. It's not the body of Christ then. We also talk about who is an apostle, and we talk about the apostle, that they are the one that Jesus Christ himself called, that no man today should take on the apostleship. No man today should call themselves apostles because they start a church or they are the founder of any churches. That's not what makes you an apostle. You continue with the work of Jesus Christ. They are teachers, they are evangelists, they are pastors. But only those who are called by Jesus himself take on this name, apostle. And we say that the apostle have the blueprint of the kingdom. We say that the prophet work alongside the apostles to read the blueprint and all of that. And we say that we have teachers. Teachers in the church is the one that keeps people from coming in and going out. And so many times we see that in the church. People get saved today and by next week and backslide. Why? There is no teaching gift that is functioning. Because you need to teach the word, not religion. We can't afford for in this dispensation and under grace. We still a teach denominational rule. And always see people poking down people church. They receive Christ, you know. The gospel has been preached and people heart was pricked by the Holy Spirit and they were led to receive Christ as Lord and as Savior. And instead we teach about Christ, we are teaching for doctrine, denominational rules. And that can't keep the people. People need to know the knowledge of the Son of God. People need to get the knowledge of the Son of God. And so that is why we see people come and go. Because where their spirit is concerned, they are not fed. They are not being the things that they need to develop them is lacking at times. I'm not saying that it's for everybody. There are some people who come in and they leave because they put other things first, of course. And you should understand that you don't put anything in front of God. Where God is concerned, when you come to him, you stay with him in spite of what? It means if even hungry, I go hungry. Stay in a God and hungry. Because he's worthy, you know. If you come to God and it means, yeah, you're putting them, I go hungry. Sometime you have to just make it happen. Because what? He is more than worthy if we be hungry for him. Because he has done so much. Whatever I go through because of God, I think he's worthy. And so I go through it. Because some of we there with some man, and we there with some woman, and we go through anything for them. How much more God? How much more the King who gave up his life as a ransom for you and I? Isn't he worthy for your beer one night or two nights or hungry man and do without some something? Do without some necessary things that you need for the sake of salvation, for the sake of your King. To prove to him you love him more than these things. Hallelujah. And so he will allow at times that we go through a certain situation to prove our love for him. We have proved our love for man that we not even have no interest in our time. That hurt we so often. And we stay with them all when they're not figure we. We make we can't stay with God too. We make we can't go without something too. And just know, say, God, are you me say? Are you me say? And if it means me I go through two nights all 1 month I'm hungry. As long as me I go dead with your God, me know say me not go dead. And when God see you willing to suffer these things, he will reward you. I'm telling you, you don't have to give up. You don't have to say, well then me not this too long, and if God love me, he would make me suffer so. Yes, little suffering of in it. Because that's how you prove love. You do a major love with what you now get from God. Hallelujah. Because when you did out there so with one man, when you have everything for you, stay with him in spite of. Right? And so somehow we really don't know love. Because as something starts to happen, we're ready to move on. And we move round in a circle. And we mess up with self. But this morning I want to say to you, give God the glory with your life. If it means say a money you now go have and the bills and sometime now go pay, allow God to be El Shaddai in your life. There is no other way that he can be El Shaddai unless situation come. We talk about the evangelist also, and we said that the teacher before that is the one who keep people in the ministry, because we need the teaching gift. And the evangelist is the person now who minister to people the healing and the deliverance, the signs and the wonders. And we said that these ministers, they oftentimes have greater revelation in this area and what they do to see this manifestation of the healing taking place, the sign and the wonders coming out of them. And oftentimes we send these people off and these people also take it upon themselves and go out and they start to travel the moment they understand who they are. And sometimes with the church that you're a part of, need for you to teach, to show them how to administrate this gift. And so it's not for us as an evangelist, whenever time we are walking in this gift, just to take up and start travel and start go all over the place. But we need, and you know that the church leaders, the pastors and the deacons and all of those persons who sit in authority and appropriate the gift, you need to identify the evangelists and do stifle them that they have to go out. You need to say to them, come on, we need you. Administrate. And so many times, the evangelists are right there. The teachers are there. And you name them. They're among us. But we go outside and we bring people in. When you are sitting down on the gift inside of you, of the church, and you stifle them. And you don't give them a chance. You know, highlight them. Because that's where people are going to think and where people are going to say, look here, you are not about people. The program and where people are, as a pastor, you are set over the congregation to make decisions, and you must discern the gifts that are among you and use them, appropriate them to the ministry that the ministry can develop. It can come to something. And so the evangelists play a great role in your midst. Look for the gift them. Now sit down and watch what people are going to say and what people are going to do when you start to use certain people. Because if they are gifted, the gift is for the congregation. Allow these persons. Allow them. And stop wondering what people are going to say. Because if God anoint them to do certain things, then use them to the honor and the glory of God. Highlight them. Show them forth. And let them come in. Our God, I call them in a fully. And then after you get it from them and the teaching and all of that, then you can send them out. And I said to the church should be responsible for these people. If it is a minister that need your full-time attention, we need to pay their rent, pay their water, pay their light. Take care of this person. Take him on to the staff. And where the church is concerned, the church is lacking in many areas, right, because we are not doing what we're supposed to do as the body of Christ. And we put who we want to put where. And sometimes who is there not even get the support from the church, because the church nothing say, I should have them did it. Are certain persons in the congregation. But pastors, I say to you, be on the lookout for these gifts. Because the ministry need the fivefold ministry into the church, so the church can grow in God. And so, for the kingdom, the evangelists have a greater revelation of certain gifts. Where the sign and wonders is concerned, they have the revelation and knowledge. So let them pass it on to the congregation before they leave. The members must unify to the work. Stop fighting within. Stop with the denominational fight. Say no to any doctrine that will bring separation. And so this is what the church, that is called the church, is going through. The fight within. And so God is saying to us this morning, if my people that are called by my name would just humble themselves, stop talking about their own belief, stop and unite. This is a year where the enemy really licked the body of Christ for six, you know, because too much, you know, they're all over the place and the little something were divided, you know, some foolishness one don't understand. And as I said last week, they say, when I say me a baptized, not the name, and when I say me a baptized, and I didn't name separate them. And the Bible tells us again that we are of one spirit, one Lord, one baptism. One baptism of the Holy Spirit. A one spirit, the world that we have. And if we have one spirit, why are we looking at the Bible in a war? I remember one time Paul addressed the nation and he said, someone who said, no, Paul, or someone who said, no, Apollos. And all of the foolishness, it need to cut out. The church can't even unite in one prayer breakfast. And so, this is it, you know. You come to prayer breakfast and you see one set of people. You see one set of people. Maybe you see the Baptist or the Methodist or the Church of God. They not invite nobody else to tabernacle among them because they not share the same belief. Now, what hypocrisy is this? And we hear say baptism are going on a New Testament and we not rejoice for New Testament because of full church. The Bible says angel in heaven rejoice when one sinner come to God. Now who we are giant people to? To we denominational belief or to the body of Christ? Who is it? Because whichever church have baptism, as long as that Jesus name them a call upon, then we should rejoice. As long as it is in Christ, we should all rejoice because we understand then that we, the body of Christ, have been had to. Right? I remember, I think it was Peter that they went out and the disciple came back to him. Or one of those, and if it's not Peter, it's Jesus. And he said, the disciple was telling him that they see people outside doing sign and wonder, healing people in the name of. And he said, Lord, what about those? And he said, who for name them a call upon? And they tell him that it was in the name of Jesus. And he said, then look here. That is it. We don't fight against our one another. We don't fight against ourselves. We don't fight against ourselves, but we rejoice in the Lord and be exceedingly glad because great is our reward. We at the body of Christ need to unite and keep where the denominational belief because it not profit the church. The church need to come to the full attention and understand whose we are. We don't belong to the denominational body. We are the body of Christ. One spirit, one baptism. And if we are one, why we are fight about little things and little discrepancies in the Bible? Come on. Get rid of the foolishness because it is the devil himself who is doing it among us. And he used those things and caused terrible division among us. And because we don't unite, we cannot see where we are going. Because the Bible says unity is strength. And because we not unite, we see so other people outside and mimic the church. And then unite themselves. And if the demon from hell do they fight each other when they want to destroy good, they come together and they unite. And they have what they are doing because unity is strength. But I say to you this morning, we need the body of Christ to be united from all over the world. We need to come together as one. And we need to put our difference aside. And we need to unite because God is one. And I say to you this morning, put away the religious belief. Put away the denomination and believe and come together and stand flat-footed believing on the Lord Jesus Christ. Because it's his body. He is the head. No fewy. And as I said before, what we are supposed to be doing, other people is doing it. Right? Other people is doing it. Nowadays we got the gay and the lesbian march and we take upon ourselves and say it can't happen and it can't happen and we are going to march too. But is that what you're supposed to be doing? Is that what you're supposed to be doing? No! Your march must be in intercession for these people. Because guess what? We did not understand what God called us to do. We see these people come together and they unite. And when you go in at some place, you see, when I go to the airport and the different places around the world, when I watch movies, me see black people with white baby and white white people with black baby. And you wonder what in God's heaven is going on. You see the humanity here and they go across the world and they adopt children from all over. And they're starting something when me and you still not understand it. And this was supposed to be the work of the church. We were responsible for the widows and the orphaned. We were supposed to go out and adopt these children and make them part of our congregation. But we not do it because we have so much power agenda to deal with. And there's something in our plan. And as a result, we see that the unsaved and the ungodly, they mimic the church and what we now do, them are do. And they are doing these things. And what they are doing, they are discipling the nations of the world to come on their side. And we sit down inside a church and clap on and sing. And some of the time when we go to church, we fall asleep and yawn. And we think that we are having a good time. And all we do, we preach to each other every day, night in, day out, day in. And we still do the same thing over and over. And the world is not joking. The devil is not playing. We need a strategy. We need a planning. We need to go back to the drawing board. We need to go back to the word of God and see what we are about and begin to do what we are supposed to do. Time we spend a quarrel about who for church right because who are baptized in that name. We would not do what we need to do because we see these people, they are not joking. In California, when the gays and lesbian case was thrown out of other state, and the gays and lesbian, they take it over to the court of California, and when they take the case before the judge there, you know what happened? The judge there give them the right because this was a gay judge. He gave them the right to have same-sex marriage because of whose vice is in the system. And we sit down for decades and say, church, no, church people not for being a politics, and church people not for become liars, and church people not for become judge. And where is our voice? You have politicians in the USA that move people from one state to the next. And they find jobs for these people. And they establish them and they take care. And then give them work for doing in one other state. You know what them a do? Them a disciple them in a one place. We get them vote when voting time come. And with the church, we just sit down. And we not no strategy. We not no planning. How do we win the loss? How? It's time our focus should be on winning the loss. We are not focused on these things. We are not focused. We are not. It's not our priority. The loss to us, we are all right. If we understand how church people segregate themselves, when you go to them, they're in their own kind. Then go out with their own kind. Then hairdresser a Christian, them barber a Christian, and then just their own people we save, and so we preach to each other. But no, we think we should march against these people. No, we think we have a voice. We say, what them I do wrong? And of course, we know say wrong. But this is this how you fight? The church was supposed to be in government, in the justice system, and in every area of society so that we would have a voice in the things. But we were taught to separate ourselves. We abdicate our duties to the world and now we want to march. Man, abdicate them duty. Where the church is concerned, we abdicate them. As minister of the gospel, we bite and devour each other. Always fighting about whose church of the most people. And we never understand that when a sinner come to Christ, no matter whose church it is, we should rejoice because heaven is rejoicing. Hallelujah. As I said before, we need planning. I hope that we would understand the function of these office and don't get caught up with the title. Some people take the bus every week to go to Kingston. This person have a lot of mileage on the bus, but you don't see the bus driver say, since you have a lot of mileage, drive the bus this morning. I say that to say this. Your mileage don't make you a driver. Your mileage in the church don't make you to run the church. Not about your mileage. Just because you're there church long, that no means you have to take over the church and run it and stop and shut down everything where God wants you doing at the church because you're in there long. You might have prayer mileage. Just because you have prayer mileage, that don't give you the right to stop what God is doing in the church. Understand what you're about. Understand who you are. Hallelujah. The apostle, the pastor, the evangelist, and the teachers are all functions of the body. If we don't understand the language, we will misuse them. Gay and lesbians are the product of abdication. They are the product of what the church tend to not do. They are very subtle. And they are turning over this earth to the power of Satan, who have no authority here. The gay and lesbian move that we, the church, fight against so hard, they are the product of abdication. The body of Christ is the authority of the earth. No wonder if we really know that. I will say this again. I said the body of Christ is the authority in the earth. Where our spiritual life is concerned, we are the authority in the earth realm. The body of Christ. Know who you are war against. And stop war against people. And see the spirits around you and take authority over them. Anywhere you establish the peace and the reign of the King in this earth, he will reign. But we are staying in our comfort zone. And we fail to establish the peace and the reign of God. We fail. The gay and lesbian move is on the rise. But right now, we just have to tolerate them. We have to tolerate them. Why? Because when we began to intercede and pray, we will pierce the darkness. We will pierce the darkness. And I said, pierce the darkness. So we don't need to go pull up my placard like the world and go against them because they are human beings. And guess what happened? We understand that this is not coming from even human being. This is something coming from the devil himself. And so we cuss them dog rotten. And we talk against them. And we say then this and then that. And some people say them for dead. But who are we to cast stones? Is that what we are called to do? We are never called to destroy mankind. We who know what spirit we are. Christ did not came to condemn the world. And neither did we. We come to save the world. We come to save gay, save lesbian, save homosexual, and all of those people out there. We are the voice of one crying in the wilderness right now. Make his path straight, not through condemnation, like religious bodies do. And so we need to start intercede. Wherever you are, it's not to go into their consequences where they are and sit down and look upon them funny. And when they come into your midst, because they're going to come to church, you know. You, as the body of Christ, you need to know how to deal with it. I'm sorry if the gay and the lesbian then come into your church and march, you know, you just start a funny look and I look upon them funny. I'm sorry for you.
Because it tell me, say, you don't know who you is and what you're about. You're not ready for embrace them yet. And this is it. You are not embracing the sin. You are embracing the person. Because how can you show somebody the love of God if you don't embrace them? How? Talk to me. Because you just ready for kill the sin and this, everybody perish. But God is not for that. God is not in agreement with the sin, but he loved the sinner. And as I said before, this is a move that is on the rise, and they are going in. They are going up, and they want to take over the world. But we, as the believers, we need to intercede for them. We need to, when we go into where they are, we need to release the reign of the King in that place. We need to release something out of our mouth. We need to pray for them. We need to begin to intercede, and we will pierce the darkness. Because they are in darkness. They're under spells. They're under controls by demons and devils. Going against them and scorning them will not help. But we need to intercede so we can pierce the darkness. Anywhere we go and establish the reign of the King, it will be established. Because we are the authority in the earth. And when you understand who you are in the earth, you are not afraid to take down demonic kingdoms. Because the Bible tells me that one shall chase 1,000 and 2 put 10,000 to flight. You don't know who you are. You don't know who you are. You don't fight like the world with sticks and stones and terrible words. You intercede. Intercede for these people. When you intercede and pray and open your mouth and speak and release the reign of the King into the, let me say, little by little, they might look like said enough. They might look like said they might take over earth. They may look like, but little by little, the bread of God said, the kingdom of God is like east that a woman in into a door. So God sent someone to some place. And he said, boy, I pay a gay and lesbian there. So me can't. Look here, man. You are there for a purpose. You need to release the reign of the King right there. Because look here. Let me tell you something. You see, when you start to release and the establishment of the King start come up, the darkness will be pierced. And you will hear gay crying out. And you will hear lesbian crying out. And these people will be made whole. But you need to know who you are. Don't give up. As I said before, right now they are rampant and enough for you to go against them and talk bad about them and talk about them want to be dead and this not right and that not right. Look here, man. So many things in our establishment. So many things is there that is not right. But it's how you deal with them. It's how you deal with them. People need deliverance and people don't even know how to go about it. Because here they are coming. They are going to be coming into the church. And I say to you, church leaders and deacons, prepare yourself. Get understanding and get wisdom. But how to deal with these things, because they are already in the church as we speak. How you deal with them? You need wisdom. You need wisdom. You need wisdom. Because that is when you're going to reach them. When I say man, well, and come to church, what you gonna do? Look upon them and make the whole of your time take up in a worship and watch them. What them I do? Come on. You need not to pay any attention to that. You need to stand flat footed. You need to worship God and you need to pray and you need to love those people. Don't give up. Don't think that they are winners. We just need to go into this place and establish the King reign. Establish his reign. The Lord is giving us. The Lord just want to give you a synopsis of the gospel this morning. And I'm closing. This is a synopsis of the gospel that the Lord wants to give us this morning. And it is like this. God created, God delegated, Satan instigated, man abdicated and fabricated, God recreated and reiterated, Satan articulated. True Christ, man is exhilarated, authority delegated, believers authenticated, earth through the shed blood replicated, satanic power extricated, kingdom of God facilitated, redeem human to be gravitated, saints from grace to be excavated, victory over sin to be escalated, return of Jesus to usher those in who is emancipated, finish work of Christ and save soul on earth, we will duplicated, return of Jesus we anticipated. And that is just a synopsis of the gospel, what we should be about. So we are not, we're not worried about what we see the enemy are doing this end time and age. We as the authority, as the kingdom of God, as the representative, as the ambassador, we need to establish the reign of the king in the earth. And stop worrying about what people are doing. Me used to worry about demonic setups, demonic operation, and where people are in a chant, and where people are spill, and where people are. I don't worry anymore because I understand who I am and who me serve. And he will not allow you, he will not allow anything to destroy you. And so just take up back your duties. Let us pierce the darkness together. Let us go to the lost sheep, let us bring them back home, because the harvest is ripe. The harvest is ripe. Everything is ready. Just the laborer them we are wait upon now. Me say we are wait upon the laborer, which is the body of Christ. They do not understand their function and what they are about. And so, as the leaders and the ministers, we need to educate the body of Christ. This morning, I want to leave the blessings of God with you. And even as Ephesians read, it said, I therefore, the prisoner of the Lord, beseech you that ye walk worthy of this vocation wherein ye are called. Ministers, leaders, walk worthy. Consider the function. Know about the function. Study the function. Understand the function, not the title. He said, with all lowliness and meekness, this is how you do it, with long suffering, forbearing one another in love. Spirit in the bonds of peace. He said, there is one body and one spirit, even as you are called into one hope of your calling. One Lord, one faith, one baptism, one God and Father of all, who is above all and through all and in all. So what we are fighting for? But unto every one of us is given grace according to the measure of the gift of Christ. Wherefore, he said, when he ascended up on high, he led captivity captive and gave gifts unto man. You are privileged this morning. You have been given all that you need to make this walk a success. We have been given apostles. We have been given prophets. We have been given teachers. We have been given pastors. We have been given evangelists. Those are the gifts that God gave to man to develop the body of Christ. This morning, I say to leaders from all over Jamaica, look here, develop the church. Stop taking on the responsibilities to yourself and highlight the gifts that are among you. Bring them into maturity and show them off. Let the enemy know that you know what you're about. Hallelujah, because you are not by yourself. You have the Holy Spirit of God inside of you. And even as you so acknowledge him to be Lord,
to be your help. He will lead you into all truth. This morning I bless the king on your behalf. And his verse 9 said, know that he has sinned. What is it? But that he also descend first into the lower part of the earth. Yes, he went to hell for you and I. That you and I wouldn't have to go. And he's ascended now. He's seated at the right side of the king. And he said, he that descend is the same also that is ascend up far above all heaven, that he might fill all things. And he gave some apostles and some prophets and some evangelists and some pastors and teachers for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, for the edifying of the body of Christ. People need to know the truth. Edify them with what God is all about. Not with fear one or something. Till we all come into the unity of faith and of the knowledge of the Son of God unto a perfect man. This is where we should strive to be. This is our goal in the body of Christ. To come into that perfect man. Unto the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ. We have to come into the fullness of Christ. If we do not understand the fullness of Christ, how are we going to come into it? If the church do not teach who Christ is, then how are we going to come into the fullness of Christ? And he said that we henceforth be no more children, tossed to and fro, and carry about with every wind of doctrine, by the sleight of man, and cunning craftiness, whereby they lie in wait to deceive. You see it? If we not teach the truth in love, other people are going to teach them. And what we need to teach, we don't need to teach philosophies of man. We don't need to teach traditions. We don't need to teach religion. We need to teach Christ and his shed blood. Hallelujah. And so when we look around, we see people tossed to and fro. They don't know their left from their right. People in the church, me attack, you know. Never mind the unsafe, because them really don't know nothing already. Right? Then just need to hear the truth and come to God and be taught, be built up, be edified. Hallelujah. But we who are in the church, we see ourselves still ignorant, still don't know what we are about, still fighting with ourselves. But in say, verse 15, but speaking the truth in love may grow up into him in all things, which is the head, even Christ. God intend for us to grow up. And if we be in a 45-year, what a church we're in a church 50 and 60 years, and still don't know nothing. Me see it. I see this in church. People in there for 50 and 60 years and don't know a head from foot about God. They don't know. And all they preach is story. And tell story. Then tell Bible story and not even tell it right. And then talk about their life and what they did there. And then sit down in a church and talk some something. And you don't get nothing out of it. You go in same way, you come out same way. Because guess what? You're not edified. And so, because of these people operate ignorantly in the body of Christ. And we can't get no healing. And we can't see the prayers, what we pray come true. Because we are not being edified about who we are and who God is to us. Verse 16 said, from whom the whole body fitly joined together and compact by that which every joint supplieth according to the effectual working in the measure of every part, make it increase of the body unto the edifying of itself in love. So you see, all are we needed. Every man has been given a measure of faith. And when we put all of the measure of them together, we will complete the full man. Then enough time for we are bite and devour one another. We need each other. The song says, you need me. I need you.
We are all a part of God's family. You pray for me, I'll pray for you. You know, go outside and say, we don't need sister lady there, we don't need Mr. Man there because he can't go along. And we push out your brother and your sister. And we think we have fault and we find fault with them. But God is saying, look here, we are all needed to make this thing work effectively. This I say, therefore, and testify in the Lord, that ye henceforth walk not as other Gentiles walk in the vanity of their mind. How much worldly things we are doing at the church. And we do things according to what we hear other people say. And we do what they want we to do. And we are not following the leading of the Spirit. Having the understanding darkened, being alienated from the life of God through the ignorance that is in them because of the blindness of their heart. Still not understand the word. Because they are not being properly fed. And some of you get food. As all when me a go down a came, they don't get food. Uno get good food too. But because we harden we heart and we fail to consider what we have been taught, I say to you this morning, consider the promise of God. Because without you think upon them and consider them and ponder them over in your heart, your heart will be made hard to them. Anything when you not consider, you can't get it. So if a promise was made, what are you thinking on the promise? What you fail to consider is what you will fail to see manifesting in your life. So we are alienated because of our own hardened heart. Right? That causes blindness. And so when we pray ignorant too. Because we don't start see God for who God is yet. So we pray and we pray and meet. And we wonder, oh God, now come true for we yet. And we wonder why our prayers are not being answered. You need to check out. Check out some things. Do you know the truth of God? Do you know the truth about God? Or do you know God? He said, who being past healing have given themselves over unto lasciviousness to work all uncleanness with greediness. And this is verse 19 and verse 20 said, but ye have not so learned Christ. If so be that ye have heard him and have been taught by him as the truth is in Jesus, that he put off concerning the former conversation, the old man, which is corrupt according to the deceitful lust. And so we still see people operating at the old man because we will not allow our mind to be renewed with the word of God. We harden we heart against. Some of we know, it makes sense we talk about renewing the mind, you know, because we still not believe what the word say. Because as soon as we get sick, we not say, all right, his word say by his stripe, I am healed. We are not considering those things. We not even stop fitting about it. We live natural. We live in our carnal self, same way. Even though we come to receive the Lord as King and as Savior into our life, we still operate carnally. We still function in a carnality. We are still weak and we are still in the flesh. And just like the world murmur, so we murmur. Everything what the world do, so we do. Why not now, one? The building come. And me say, no money, no day. Everything raise. Of course, that happen. But what the word of God say about you? He said, we are in the world, but not of the world. How should your conversation be now? Instead of murmuring like the world, you should be thanking God for his provisions for you. Because you are in the world, but not of the world. That means your provision will come from somewhere else. He is the one. The word of God said the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. Do the devil control the system of the world in a control earth? And so when you have need of anything, if you can believe what God say about you and consider it, then you will manifest it. but you will not even bring your mind to think about it. As a result, we cannot see the manifestation of the King coming into our lives. We can't benefit from the inheritance because we might not renew. As believers this morning, as leaders and as ministers, we too need a renewed mind so we can uplift the body of Christ. We can bring them into a clearer knowledge of God. We can bring them, we can edify them. We can allow people to come into maturity. And we are needed. We are needed where God is concerned with the gifts, the ministering gift. So if you are put into an office, whether you are deacon or you are pastor or you are prophet or whoever you is, appropriate the gift. Allow the functions of this gift to be manifested. And listen to the Holy Spirit and His leading. Because the body of Christ need you. The body of Christ need the ministering gift to be flowing out effectively so that the church can be edified. When the church is edified, the church will now come into the full stature of Christ. When we come into the full stature of Christ, we will see the mandate. And we will establish it in the earth. And we will harvest the world. God is waiting on the church to stop being divided. To stop seeing self. And to see Him. Hallelujah. To quit our program. And to allow the spirit program to come into our midst. I leave that with you this morning. Because God is not the author of confusion. What we have among us right now is confusion. And He wants to stop the confusion because it is of the devil. The division is of the enemy. And I say to you, leaders and ministers, you are responsible to allow those gifts to function in the body of Christ. God bless you, each and every one of you this morning. As you take up on what I have just said, see if you make no sense out of it. See what me I say. And appropriate these things to your life. And watch the darkness being pierced.
Don't think for a moment I never felt the pain. The hurt and the shame. They put the nails through my head, pierced my side. Please understand, it wasn't easy, but it was worth it.
Jesus, death wasn't easy. He paid the price for you and I. And after He did His part, of course, there is something that He has given to man. Let us receive it this morning and appropriate it.
It wasn't easy. It wasn't easy.
This one said, good morning. Please pray for me. I am Chantel. I am pregnant. Pray that when I am ready to have my baby, everything work out good. And right now, Chantel, I release safe delivery to you right now in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Father, I thank you for safe delivery of that child and mother. No lives will be lost. We thank you, Almighty God.
I die for your sins, yes, I'm the one. Don't take it lightly what I've done.
This one said, good morning to you all. Pray for me and my family. I have pure problem, Pauline, from Orange Bay. My dear, problem is a must.
especially if you're a believer. You should know how to cope with problem. But as I said before, problem is a must. You notice that all of we have problem, both unsaved and saved have problem. But the difference between the unsaved and the saved is that you have somebody. The Bible said, many are the affliction of the righteous, but the Lord delivered them from them all. And so outside of God and Christ, Pauline, if you have not said yes to his will and his way, you have not given him the right to fight for you, to fight on your behalf. And so you might want to step away from sin, step away from condemnation, step away from everything that the enemy has hold down over your life, and give God the right to fight for you, to deliver you from your problems. The blessings of God be with you this morning. I pray for you that you will be successful. I pray that the peace of God that passes all understanding will be upon your lives and that of your family. And I pray that salvation will come to your house in Jesus' name. And this one said, good morning, my name is Shamor Garden. I want you to pray for the Garden family, for we to get our over our problem. As I said before, problems in life is a must, but is where you are, who you are with in these trying times. You have problems, but you need somebody in your corner. You need Jesus. If you have not given your life to him, if you have not given your life to him to allow him to fight the good fight for you, then you are on your own. You are on your own. He wants to fight for you. He wants to deliver you. He wants to make you free from everything that keep you bound. But you have to make a decision to give him your life. Because even though he heal you in a sin, you know, and he change something for you, you know, and you pray to him in a sin, and you see your prayer answer, and you say, me know say God answer sin a prayer. But notice, he answer your prayer, but he's not obligated to you. The reason he answers your prayer is because he wants you to know that he is real. He wants you to know that he is all wise, all powerful. So you need to seek after him today. Seek to know him. Seek to give him your life, because it's only when you give him the authority, it's only when you open the door to him, then he can come in and fight for you. If you have not given him that place, if you have not given him that privilege, he can't just come take you from you. So that is why he gives us free will. So I say to you, Shamor and family, consider God. And if you have already given him your life, then trust him today, because he said, many are the affliction of the righteous, but the Lord shall deliver them all. Father, I thank you for the life of Shamor and family. I thank you, Almighty God, that you are a God who wants to save, who wants to deliver, who wants to make people free. And so this morning, as she cry out, Almighty God, for prayer, you hear that cry this morning, and you are doing something about it even now. And so, Lord and Father, I release salvation to that house right now in Jesus' name. And I thank you, Almighty God, for burden being lifted. I thank you for yokes being destroyed where that family is concerned. And I give you praise in Jesus' name. Trust me, people are ball, and I wonder if the world are gonna get no better. Look here, these are the time for people to see sign and wonders from the King. Here is the song.
Come on, let's put our hands together and let's welcome to the Rock Church of Virginia Beach. Come on, put your hands together all the way from Long Island, New York. Let's hear it for Pastor Donnie McClarkin.
These are the days that we are not afraid.
Somebody give Jesus praise here.
We are not afraid of what the enemy is doing, because whatever ain't come with, we just bounce right back. So the enemy's in for a surprise in life. As him a go on like said, the majority of him. But listen to me and listen to me good. Listen to me and listen to me good. Me said the people them have to get wise. God already sworn in his word that his knowledge will cover the earth. And we know so when the knowledge of God cover the earth, people have to see him. We see many coming to God. Many is being delivered. And trust me, the devil intensifies on something even in a parliament. But guess what? It is all for the glory of the King. Intensifies on something at the political realm of the world, but it's all to the glory of the King. It's all for people to see and to know God. That when your back is against the wall, who do you run to? You run to the King. When you hit the bottom, you have nowhere else to go but go back to the top. So I said, look up, your redemption draw it nigh. As a matter of fact, idea, you have been redeemed. You just come into the manifestation. If you know, so then no God, no delight Jehovah. Let me hear you sing that one.
Yeah.
in our church in New York, Perfecting Faith Church. It's about an every Sunday song. Listen, I don't need you to get tired now. I need those of you that are going to help us stand up and we're going to give God glory.
And this one said, good morning, can you pray for M. Shirley for healing and success and for the F4 category to move faster so that we could migrate for a better and successful life. I call you. Well, F. Shirley, I want you to rejoice right now. I want you to begin to look into your life. Look back down the road, Shirley. See where something wasn't going right and God came true for you. You need to find something about to rejoice in God for this morning. Don't just stay there and hang your head down and say, nothing nah, go on me, I'll wait upon this. You need to begin to give God thanks for what he has already done. Hallelujah. You need to begin to praise the King of Kings. You need to begin to lift up your voice, open your mouth, and give God praise. And if you have not done that, or if you don't know how to do that, it tells me then that you are not a son. If you have not received God this morning as Lord and as Savior in your life, it means then that you don't know your destiny. So whether it means that you are supposed to live here in Jamaica or live abroad, you need to understand, what is God's destiny for me? It, God want me here or he want me abroad? Where? You need to find out that. Because wherever God wants you, that's where his plan and purpose will be for your life. And that's where he will keep you. Find out. What is it? Who is it? Where is your destiny? And if you have not given God your life, it means you don't know nothing about that yet. So I pray for you that you will hear the leading of the Spirit this morning. If you don't receive him yet, start to pray that you receive him. Simple prayer, Father, I thank you for life. Simple prayer, Lord, I am a sinner. Forgive me. Forgive me of all my sins. And I receive you now as Lord and as Savior of my life. And you will see his plan, his wisdom, his plan and purpose start to take shape and form in your life. But you need to understand first, where is your destiny? God bless you.
You have been. is hope. Not the form of godliness, but be holy as he is holy. We were in church one Sunday.
And this one said, Sister, I'm asking you to pray for me so I may come to him as my Savior.
Many songs like that in the middle of service.
And this one is
but then it just started to roll
Andere.
Holy.
From Buffby. Sweetheart, I pray for you. Father, I thank you right now that you know this person by name and number. You know where this person is right now, Almighty God. And Father, I thank you, Almighty God, for salvation. I release to him your salvation. Wherever he is right now, Almighty God, at the hearing of my voice, I release salvation to you. Receive it in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. He said, come unto me, all you who have labored, and I will give you rest. Andere, this morning, he wants to give you rest. If you will say this prayer with me, Lord Jesus, I know I'm a sinner. I repent of my sin, and I make you Lord of my life from now on, in Jesus' name. If you have just prayed that prayer with me and believe it with your heart of hearts that you are now saved, you are now sanctified because of what you have just done, you are saved. I invite you to come. The ministry of ambassador ministry in Spring Garden. If you can come there, because you're in Buffby and I understand that we are not too far away from you guys. So I invite you to come to church. I invite you to come hear the teaching. And as you get those teaching, I know that you will grow. Right? We are right there in Spring Garden. Spring Garden is a little way out of the town of Buffby, coming back. Like you're coming to Port Antonio. You just come up. Turn into Spring Garden where they have the water plant and those areas. That's where we are located. Once you come into the lane, there's a shop. You can ask direction from anybody there to show you Pastor Somo's church or Brother Bobby. It is now pastored by Denise Spalding. You might just come in. I'm giving you an invitation. You think that you ask me to pray for you that you will receive salvation, but salvation is already yours. And so I leave that with you this morning, and that invitation is to you to come in, because you have just received it. The fact that you ask, it is already yours. Come in and get the teaching and grow in God. God bless you.